Hello and welcome to this video tutorial. Gareth here from tastetudes.com. In the last episode, we completed the book cover design by adding the final type elements to the composition. In this tutorial, I'm going to discuss and demonstrate how I will finalise the design and look at how to export the artwork ready to be supplied to the printers for print. So here we are where we left off in the previous tutorial with the document open. Now this design is pretty much complete, but what I'm going to do now is just refine the positioning of some of the elements. So I'll start with the clouds here. Now if I want to change the position of any of these clouds, I can come into the Layers panel and double click on the Header Smart Object. Once open, with the Move tool, I'll right click on the cloud I wish to move, I'll select it in the Layers panel, and I can move it into a better position. Should I wish, I can also select the type, the balloon, and the rainbow, and edit those as well. So now I'll spend a few minutes positioning and refining everything correctly. Once happy, I'll press Command W to close and save, and that will update in the main document. If I'm still not happy, I can go back and forth into the smart objects and keep tweaking until it's right. Next, I'll pay attention to the birds. In the birds folder, I can move them around individually and scale them up and down using the free transform tool. I'll make sure to get the perfect composition. I'll press Command Colon and make sure everything is comfortably inside the inner margins. And once I am 100% happy with the positioning of every element in the design, I am now ready to export for print. So before I send any document to print, there are a few things I need to be certain of. I need to be sure that the color mode is set to CMYK, ideal for print. I need to be sure that the resolution is set to a suitable value, at least 300 dpi. And I need to be sure that the canvas size is correct. Now at the start, when we set up the document, we were very conscious about setting up the right document settings. So now I'll just double check. So I'll press Command and Alt and press I. This will pull up the image size menu. So I'll click on the values and set this to millimeters. Great. So we can see that this document is 150 by 230 millimeters with the additional 3 millimeter bleed applied. And the resolution is set to 300 dpi. So this document is just the right size. I'll click OK. Lastly, I'll check to make sure the color mode is correct. I'll come up to Image, Mode, and I can see there is a check next to CMYK. Great. So all conditions are perfect. Now I can save for print. So on this occasion, I'm going to supply the printers with a JPEG image. This will be a flat image, and they will take this image and put it into their print deck for the entire book. Now sometimes you may wish to send the entire PSD file with all the layers. Though to keep it simple, on this occasion, we will just send a flat JPEG. So I'll come up to File and choose Save As. In the format, I'll change this to JPEG. I'll navigate to My Project folder in the Project folder. I'll rename this file to Paper underscore Friends underscore Cover underscore Print underscore CMYK underscore 300 dpi underscore 3 millimeters underscore bleed. So that's just summing up this document here. It's CMYK set to 300 dpi with a 3 millimeter bleed. Now I don't have to name it this way, but this will instantly inform the printer of the nature of the document. So I'll click Save. Next, in the JPEG options, I'll push the quality to maximum. We don't want any compression here. This needs to be as high quality as possible for print. Then I'll click OK. Now, if I navigate to My Project folder and take a look, we can see the new JPEG file inside. So this file is now ready to send to the printers for print. Excellent. So that's it, guys. That completes the design and export of this book cover design. If you have made it this far, well done. Thank you for sticking with me, and I very much hope you have enjoyed this part of the course. Now, believe it or not, it does not end there. Yes, I have more to share with you, and yes, there is more to learn. So we have just set up this entire design ready for print. In the next video, I will be demonstrating how we can take the book cover design and adapt it into digital artwork for a web banner. So I'll see you in the next video.